Good afternoon, and welcome to our third in a series of six Lindsey Chapel series concerts. As always, we're grateful to Emmanuel Church to be able to present once again in this incredible acoustic and beautiful Lady Chapel. This year's series is unique in that we've paired solo string works by Bach with contemporary works. Today is an example of how a solo string work which was not intended for the instrument on which it's being played, as we have a contrabass playing one of the cello suites. And also, how do the works of Bach sort of posthumously engage in dialogue with contemporary works? One of the other unique things about this series is that the repertoire was chosen not by myself, the concept was, but the repertoire was chosen by the performers themselves, so that they were aware of what pieces they might want to play that would be in dialogue with the Bach that they have chosen. Please make sure you have any cell phones, they're turned off, and I'll also want to point your attention to two upcoming activities at Emmanuel. The first is that this Monday evening, Pamela Dalal, mezzo-soprano and co-director of the Bach Institute, will be presenting on Zoom a discussion about the stages of grief in the St. John Passion. This will have a focus on the three meditative arias that happen toward the end of the Passion. If you know Pam Dalal, she's absolutely brilliant, eloquent, and this will no doubt be an interesting conversation you won't want to miss. It's free, but you do need to register in advance on our website. The second thing is that next Saturday, March 26th at 7 p.m., we will be presenting Bach's monumental work, the St. John Passion, right here in the sanctuary, and we sure hope you will join us for that as well. It's great to see all of you in person. We're thrilled to be back here in the Lindsey Chapel, and please join me in welcoming our performer today, bass player Nathan Varga.
Thank you. thanks all for being here and everyone also watching online. It's really a huge privilege to be part of this series and a musician with Emmanuel Music. I'm also in the midst of the Lorraine Hunt Lieberson Fellowship here, which is also really, really an honor that was given to me. And you know, to be in the footsteps of some of the other fellows in the past is really, I'm super, super honored by that. Obviously, music of Bach on the first part of the program, it's always a huge challenge to approach, especially for this instrument. And as you can see, it was transcribed as well, just to put it in a place where you as the audience get to hear more of the low notes that you want to hear. But yeah, it's always a real privilege to work on that music. Always, you know, something more to be done, but Bach does show us that. The second piece on the program is by, I think, one of the most unknown bassists that's alive today, by non-bass players. So Francois Rabbath is a prolific player and teacher, as well as a composer, mostly for the double bass. He is just such a special guy. I would really encourage you to take 45 minutes and watch a masterclass that is on YouTube by him that he did at a college. And it's really, he talks about himself, he talks about his relationship to the instrument, and how much the music of Bach has meant to him as well. He really is one of these guys that has come at the bass from no prior training. So he was able to set out and say, I want to be able to do this, and he found a way to do it. Whereas with traditional schools of playing, sometimes you are almost instantly put into a box. But he, fortunately for us all, that was not his experience. And he's really done so much to advance bass playing itself. And his pieces show that. He's 91 years old, I believe, and he's still getting better, believe it or not. And one of my teachers described it to me as he never stops, so he's always warmed up. And he's one of these guys that needs to be led away from the bass to like eat and things like that. But I really hope you enjoy this piece. It's called Voyage. And for me, it's a very nautical piece. I love being by the water. And it has this sense of kind of call and answer, something that's far away and something you'll eventually get to. And then a return, and you're all the more wise. Also, this week kind of had a special connection for this piece with me because the Endurance was found in about 10,000 feet of water, I believe, which is a very special story as well, story of Sir Ernest Shackleton. And that ship being found, one of the last major shipwrecks that was very important, being found is kind of added a resonance to this piece for me today. So hopefully you enjoy Voyage by Francois Rabbath.
Mm-hmm.